Hi everyone, we've had so many requests for a full garden tour that we're going to give it to you today. And actually, believe it or not, camera guy is on top of the fountain with his wide angle lens on, and he's going to do his best to get you a full 360 degree tour of our garden. So first of all, right behind me, of course, you probably see our house. And if you've watched our channel for very long, you know that we live on a hill. So we're actually showing you our garden and yard is on the downslope of our hill. So that's the first thing. And if you go right to camera left is where I have my giant pumpkin patch, just to the camera left of the fountain. And hiding under there is my giant pumpkin, which hopefully will be a winner in the contest this year. Then we move on to one of our decks. And then we move on to how we access our yard on one side through the steps. And then the first planting area where you've seen the red containers many times on my channel. And that's where we have that area. And behind me here on the hill, I have several different things planted, which I'll go into more detail later. Then coming around here to this grassy area and moving on to the camera right, which is where I have most of my tomatoes and other things planted on the other side of the house where we have a hill over there. Then moving along, we have a couple of raised beds, or one raised bed, and then the other deck that we have down below, and the other raised bed along the back fence. So that's pretty much, oh, and then the middle area is our fountain and our fountain planter. So that's kind of the general layout of the land. And now we'll go and do some close-ups of the specific planting areas that I have. Okay, so starting over here with our pumpkin patch, camera guy climbed down from the fountain to do our first shot here of the giant pumpkin patch. And you guys have seen those videos, I'm sure. If you haven't, make sure you go back and watch the giant pumpkin growing series. We've got a big giant pumpkin here under the sheet, a couple smaller ones over in the pumpkin patch, and also our tomato grow bags, which we've got a video coming up on that within a couple of days, and our lemon tree, which we're still working on getting planted, so be watching for a video on that in the next few weeks. And then over here we have our deck, which is our favorite place to sit in the garden. We love to sit out here in the mornings and have coffee, have a glass of wine in the evenings as we plan our garden projects and plan our videos for you guys to watch. So let's head over to the next area of the garden. So just to the one side of our deck here, I have some cucumber plants, which are kind of looking a little frazzled from the heat. And I've got some basil, which I actually did a video a while back on trimming basil and getting basil to grow nice and bushy. So that's where that is. And then we're moving along here. We've got our steps that we access the backyard, and our planter area here with the red planters that so many of you have commented on. And just so you guys know the story on those, we actually got those when we were redoing our backyard. It was originally a piece of galvanized steel, a big long piece of galvanized steel pipe that a local farmer had. Got it from him, cut that up, spray painted it, and threw it in the ground here as planters, and I think they really turned out nice. I really like them. It's a great area to keep herbs contained. I do have some mint planted in the back, which, as you guys know, mint is extremely invasive. So for me, it works really well in a planter, so it just doesn't spread all over the garden. And I have my onions planted over here in another one of them. Lots of marigolds, got some peppers, a whole bunch of other herbs in here, some Thai basil and oregano, more peppers in here and onions. So a tomato plant, and I also have spread it throughout here a watermelon vine, which I've only gotten a few watermelons on. I don't know why, the watermelons just aren't hitting it big for me this year, but I also have some sunflowers back there, which I always love to have sunflowers in the garden, as you guys well know. So this area here is just a little hill area above my red planter bed, and basically I really try to use most of the space in my garden as best I can. So up in here I've planted some squash. I have some butternut squash, some zucchini squash, which actually aren't looking too good right now. I think I need to add some compost and things like that on them to get them going again. They're looking a little yellow, little powdery mildew. And up in here in the spring, I planted some berry bushes, some raspberries, which I'm actually just starting to get a few little raspberries. I haven't really done a lot with these, so I really need to research and read up a little bit more on berry bushes and what to do to get those going a little bit more. So now we're moving to the other side of the house, the hill on the other side. And here you can see some winding steps that we use to access this side. And this is primarily where I have most of my tomatoes. If you saw the recent video on my tomato, on the tomato hornworm, my tomato plant boost, we did that. We shot that right at the top of the hill here, those tomato plants right up there. And I'm still having problems with those tomato hornworms. mushrooms. In fact, tonight after shooting this, I need to go through and pick a bunch of them off. But anyway, this is where I have the majority of my tomato plants. I also have in this area a cucumber plant and some peppers, all kinds of varieties of tomatoes, and lots of basil as well. So this is where I pick the majority of my basil. And just some flowers scattered throughout. I really like to plant flowers throughout the garden for a burst of color. I love the color of the flowers. Also brings in the bumblebees. And this is really where I have the bulk of my garden. So now we're moving around the yard here, the fence here, and this raised bed. We actually did a video a few weeks ago. We took the old soil out, put some new soil in. Over the summer, this is where I had my scarlet runner beans, some zucchini, but we're getting this ready for fall planting. So it's, you can see it's empty right now, but hopefully soon a video coming on what I'm gonna plant there. Okay, so back here I have my cantaloupe watermelon patch, and this really is just about done for the season. Getting a lot of aphids in it, just drying up. The fruit is just about finished, and I'm not sure again what I'm gonna do with this winter, but we'll figure something out. I've also got all these zinnias growing back here, which I really love. They just add so much color to the garden. The seeds are so easy to save. I just love to spread them all over the place as they dry up, and that way they pop up first in the spring or whenever the weather gets warm enough. So the next area we're gonna talk about, oh, and I wanted to show you right here. This is the grapevine we planted in the 5-gallon buckets, and I'm still trying to figure out a nice sunny location to build a grape trellis. And just to wrap up our full 360 tour of the garden, here we have our fountain planter, which I think is but without a doubt the sunniest spot in the garden. So I really try and plant heat-loving plants here. And I've got a lot of peppers here. Planted a bunch of different variety of peppers. In fact, this one's getting so heavy. You can tell it's falling over. I need to get a heavier duty stake for that one. But all along in here, different varieties of peppers, sweet peppers on this side primarily. I've got some Thai basil that is going to seed and flowering, but I just love these purple flowers. They smell so good. I love the Thai basil. And I do try and plant marigolds throughout my garden because they do help deter pests. And I just like the way they look. Plus, they're super, super hardy. They last a long time here. They last through the heat and even into the winter time. So a lot of peppers in here and chard. And also, I've got some eggplant growing, which I haven't really talked a whole lot about my eggplant yet, but they're actually doing very well in the heat. And along in here, I've got some hot peppers planted. I did try and separate the sweet peppers and the hot peppers, because last year I got a lot of them, cross-pollinating. So my peppers that were supposed to be sweet got hot, and unfortunately the hot peppers didn't get sweet, but I tried to give a little bit of distance to hopefully cut down on that. So I've got some good varieties of hot peppers here, and also a lot of volunteers in this section too. Some cucumber plants, a tomato plant, which I'm actually just gonna let grow because I need tomatoes over the winter time, and why not? Some basil going to seed, and back in here, some borage. And along the back row here, I just threw down a bunch of various flower seeds to give some color. And I threw down some arugula, which is coming in very nicely. And just kind of trying a mixture of things back here in the fountain planter. So there it is. Hope you enjoyed the tour. And if there's an area you'd like us to cover more in depth in a video, please let us know. So thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you next time.